Hello everyone, welcome to Live from the Hen House. We're about to start and I'm slightly ahead of the schedule or behind schedule, but we'll see you soon. Here is the introduction.
Know, so, is he thinking, this valve's a bit tight?
Ooh. This is not what we meant when we said we were going to have a ball on the beach.
Hey.
Steve, I just realised he looks a bit like you.
that's ageist. That is. That's sorry. Terrible.
This is Boris waves to his children from the required legal distance of 100 yards.
That's good. That is good. I would put Boris waves fond farewell to the Labour Party.
Sad but true.
Oh, not funny. Too soon?
Too soon!
We had a weekend. It was last weekend in Powick, right? That's at the foot of the Malvern Hills. I actually proposed to my wife on top of the Malvern Hills, although she said it was too cold, so we did it in the back seat of the car. Are you icky wicky poorly?
Yeah.
Well,
I'm struggling to get any words out.
I know I don't look it, but I'm 41 and I'm just sort of feeling really shit. I mean, don't look it in the face, but you should see my vagina. Oh dear.
Oh, Scotland's going to break away. Jimmy Cranky's got control.
I'm not great at sports, but I still like them. You guys like sports? We love them in America. We don't love your sports, British people, but we love sports.
Spanking Dwayne Johnson, Lady Owen. Spanking Dwayne Johnson. That was when I really knew I'd hit rock bottom. So I did. I went over to Hollywood, actually. That's where I met Dwayne Johnson. That's where I ended up spanking. I was over in Hollywood. I went for a job and they said to me, so, Mr. Cowards, could you tell us why you'd like to be a film editor? I said, well, to cut a long story short. And they gave me the job. So that was nice. Yeah, the hardest job I ever had in Hollywood, though, the hardest job I ever had was being the publicist for the film Fight Club. Thank goodness I'm here and thank goodness you're there. I can't believe it, right? For the first time in weeks, we've got 16 viewers. So thank you so much. I'm assuming you're here for, we've got a double header tonight.
And I know, in America, that doesn't sound rude. But in here, in this room, when I'm all on my own, it sounds slightly pervy. Right, who have we got saying hello? We have had people coming in. We've had Alison. Alison saying stuff. And we've got Denise. And we've got lots of people coming. So, honestly, I'll just do this now. There's a little QR code there. Like, scan that. Donate some money. Keep the show live. Keep us going. Because at the end of the day, you're another day older. Yes, I'm going to stay here talking to you until I've had at least 15 donations. Look at that. It's all there. Oh, I haven't got rid of that. I'm quite excited, to be honest with you. I've never been this excited for weeks. Weeks and weeks. Also, I started the show about 3 minutes ago with a little like intro, and I was short. I was short. What does CBA mean? CBA? CBA means can't be asked. That's right. Honestly, scan it, donate. It'll just keep me going. And please. Right. Yeah, what was I saying? Yeah, we had no comedians. Now we've got three. One of them, God bless her, is driving on a road trip. I don't know where. Somewhere in America. Anyway, hopefully we'll catch up with Wendy later. She's on her way to a gig. 6 hour drive. That's like driving from one end of the United Kingdom to the other. Or if Scotland leave, then it's only a half of that. 3 hours, isn't it? Right. Do you know, today, you always wee more when it's cold. 8 times so far. I know. So, Mother Hen is having a hard time with reality this week. The doctor has been swapping around her medications and just to see which ones will work best. A few weeks ago, she was having a lot of paranoid visions, thinking that people from next door were watching her TV through the wall. It's difficult for her because she's 92 and loves Piers Morgan. She thinks they've captured him and locked him away, if only. But this last week, it was a new medication and her visions seemed to have subsided, or so we thought. I was speaking to her yesterday and she told me that she saw an old man in the corner of a room wanking. Wanking, exact words. I was horrified. I said, Mother, don't ever repeat that ever again. She said, why? I said, because they will never let me visit you again. Do you think the people who pile on when Harry talks about mental health issues miss the irony that it's them he's actually trying to help? I don't understand this fixation with Harry and his wife. The only reason he was born was in case his older brother died. You always need a spare in the royal family. Even if they do turn out to be a sexual deviant whose only defence is they can't sweat. As soon as George was born, Harry's role in life was over. That was it. 29. Thanks, mate. Job done. It's taken him 7 years to find a role for himself in life. Not for you. Not for me. Not for the toilet papers and their sister magazines. He was their cash cow. The only reason the royal family and its offspring are in the papers is because they make millions and millions of dollars for their billionaire owners. Back in the day, you could put a picture of Princess of Wales on a magazine and it would quadruple its sales. The only interest they have is the bank interest. I was quite proud of that, to be honest with you. And then what happens? A month of Christmas has come all at once. He went and fell in love. Not with a London socialite or one of his third cousins with a hair lip twice removed. The cousin was twice removed, not the hair lip. No, 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 no. He fell in love with the gilt-edged, gift-wrapped, 24-carat gold American actress who also just happened to be mixed. Ka-fucking-ching! That's not her name. Not since his mother, Diana, the fairy tale Princess of Wales, who only produced the 2 children, and as soon as she had given birth to the spare, her husband, Prince Charles, started shoving his royal penis up Camilla Parker Carr around the corner. Not since Diana had the British press found such a payday. Ka-ching! Not a name. The people who say, I hate Meghan Markle but love Harry, as if we fucking know them. It makes my tits ache. Do you think these royal experts who we glean our opinions from actually know what they are talking about? I don't know if Princess Sparkles is a cold-hearted bitch. I personally don't believe she is. No, that's not true. I don't care. I don't think Ginger Biscuits is weak-willed. No pun intended. From what I can see, and I agree, I know as much and or as little as you. I see a young family trying to live together, earning a living off the hand that they have been dealt with. Harry didn't decide to be born a spare in an archaic institution. No more than a starving child in Africa decides to be born in a mud hut in Ethiopia. It's a fluke, an accident of birth. Yet, we seem to care more about one than the other. Boom! I've had to move my microphone nearer to the screen. And, I'm going to go and see Av, because Av is about news hound, man about town, Av Singh. A bit icky wicky last week because of his vaccine. Let's see how Av is. Av, how are you, mate? Excellent. Why can't I hear you? Is that because my things aren't working?
Is that
it could
working?
Be me. Oh, yeah. It is now. Is it you? It was you.
Yeah, me. Sorry.
Don't do that. Don't do that to me so early on the show. We've got 25 viewers.
Okay.
I knew that would take your breath away.
I know it did. I'm a bit shocked by actually 25 viewers.
Don't call me Ashley.
Why?
I just don't like it.
All right, Gav.
All right, Gav. How you feeling?
Yeah, I'm okay.
That's all I needed to know. Thanks very much. Anything you want to talk about? Or should I come back to you? It was a bit of a shock just bringing you in. It's the 26 viewers now. Honestly, they can scan that QR code by your shoulder if they wanted to. Keep the show live.
I think you got to explain to them if they're from America, there's a difference in the currency rate.
And the comedy.
And the comedy as well, yeah.
That's
I think you get $1.40 for every pound.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
That'll put him off straight away.
That's it. A friend of mine's an American. He's American, and he's a pirate at Disney World or something like that. Like a proper pilot. Seriously?
Pirate?
And I saw the other... Pirate.
Oh, yes.
Jim Ladd. Yeah. And I saw him the other week. And these really new earrings. I said, they're really nice earrings. He said, thanks. They were $1 each. I said, that's not bad for a buccaneer.
Okay.
Donate now.
I think they want a refund, even though they've got given one after that joke.
All right.
sorry.
I bet you. See, look, Samantha laughed. Ha 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 ha. But I bet they're just having a personal chat, to be honest. I bet they're not laughing at me. If anyone's laughing at me, let me know, because I like that. What else? What's going on in the news, Av?
It's been a fair bit going on this week, hasn't there? I mean, the relaxation of the COVID rules. They had Michael Gove on this week, and he was saying he can't wait to see people being intimate with each other. Can you imagine him watching?
Sorry. I pressed the wrong button. I was trying to do it. I've got a touch screen. I'm enjoying myself. Come on, 28 viewers. Can we get 30? Look, people, 28 viewers that are watching, share this stream now and say watch and give Av a couple of quid. Dollars. Right.
Yeah, so can you imagine him watching you with his cheeky face?
Imagine it. I dream about it.
I reckon he watches Boris when he's he's been intimate as well.
Oh, don't say. That's an image I do not want to see.
Yeah, I know. And then you mentioned, I think this week was, is it Mental Health Awareness Week?
Oh, yeah.
And we had visitors to Wolverhampton, very important visitors. Last week we had Boris.
Yes, you did.
This week we had Prince William and
I was going to say he was dead.
Meghan.
Prince and Meghan.
It's Meghan. Not Meghan, is it?
No. Meghan's in America.
It's William. And what's his wife
she
called?
She was born in the USA.
That is a terrible impression of the boss, isn't it?
No, you meant the other princess, Kate. Middleton.
Kate, that's it, yeah, Kate.
Kate, yeah.
So they visited Wolverhampton. I was like, I can't believe it. First Boris, now these two. What's going on?
Well, obviously, Wolverhampton is the metropolis of the world.
Well, not sure.
Or
is it the fact that because Boris came last week, everyone's mental health went down the pan? And they needed someone to pick me up.
Before they go.
Definitely.
Right, Av, I'm going to go because I know Shelby's here and Shelby's going to sing us a song and she's got to go and I don't want to keep her too long. And we're going to go and find Melbury. Wendy. Wendy is driving across America, Av, and she's going to pull over at a truck stop.
Route 66.
Who is this? I don't think so. But yeah, that's good. Hey, Av, pick a number.
1.
30.
30. 31.
No, 30 people. Tell them to scan the barcode and keep your hat warm.
Scan the barcode because everyone's really poor in Britain. We can't afford to brush our teeth with toothpaste.
Yeah, we have rubbish teeth.
We have bad teeth. Yeah,
bad teeth, man. Yeah. All right, Av, see you in a bit. Say goodbye to Av, everyone. Breaking news now from Av Singh. Av, what's going on in Wolverhampton?
Breaking news, Dave. I'm in trouble.
You're telling me he's in trouble. Hey, are you excited? I'm excited. We're going to go to see Shelby. I have to say that now. Just give them time to get in front of the... Oh, there we go. I'm coming now, Shelby. Hello.
Hello. Is my audio good?
Yes.
Good. I always want to check. I got a microphone.
I was going to say you've got a bit of a slight echo, but not a bad one. Like a good echo. Like a singer's echo.
Oh, God. There's no reverb on it, but that's as long as you can hear me.
No, you sound, I don't want to be rude, best you've sounded.
Fantastic. Thank you.
How are you?
I'm okay. How are you?
I'm all right, really. I'm all right. I've got things, personal stuff I've got to deal with, really doing my head in. So it's nice to do stuff like that and meet some lovely people.
Yeah.
That's you, by the way. Just in case.
Lovely you lovely too, know. Steve.
Hey, I saw your video the other day that you dropped with your new song on.
Yes.
Did you do all the video editing yourself?
Mm-hmm. I did it on Splice.
Oh, wow. It's really good.
Oh, thank you.
I mean, the song's great as well. I might see if I can play that later or put it on the Facebook page.
Oh, and then, awesome. Because I think I'm going to play it right now. So.
Oh, I... Hey, that it's like we're in tune.
Exactly. That's cool. That would be perfect.
That's good. And are things opening up more for you?
Yeah, and people are getting vaccinated like crazy. And so then the CDC said that if we got vaccinated, we don't have to wear masks anymore.
Mm. Which is good. Whereas everyone says I should wear a mask more anyway. Oh, thanks. All right, I'm gonna let you do your song and everything. All right, because
perfect.
I'm so excited. I love Shelby Taylor. I'm telling it to her now. Right, ladies and gentlemen. Back in the hen house for her umpteenth time, it's Shelby Taylor.
Hi, everybody. My name is Shelby Taylor. I'm a little quirky. I'm a little out there. I'm not like other girls. I'm a fucking nightmare. The not like other girls are making a comeback. I don't know if anybody's noticed that, but it's very like Taylor Swift circa 2010. It's very You Belong With Me. It's very... you know, she wears high heels. I wear sneakers. She wears makeup. I wear slightly less makeup. So I just figure if that's making a comeback, I'm going to sell out completely and write one of those songs. So it's called NLOG, Not Like Other Girls. And I hope you guys like it. Past my place with your girlfriend every day. You always stop, say hi, but then go on your way. She looks at me like I'm so gross and dumb and fat. And I don't know why you'd want a girl like that. She paints her face on, but I prefer a natural look. She never asks you questions, but I can read you like a book. She's pretty, but she's basic, and I'm quirky, cool, and fun. But I don't know how to be your number one. She hates the great outdoors, and I practically live outside. She hates the dirt and bugs, and I love to chase butterflies. She's a city princess, a Gucci prototype. But a Gucci bag can't be as priceless as the midnight sky. Also, I'm deep and she's not, and that's important. And also, when she goes to bed at night, she curls up in a nice duvet. And when I go to bed at night, I sleep in a pile of hay. She's super healthy. She does yoga. She's gluten-free. Everything you put in front of me, including bones. She only talks about things nobody cares about. Like, what the heck is TikTok? What's a hashtag? What is clout? What the hell is toothpaste? What is Listerine? I'm not even sure what those words mean. I've never heard them. She smells like perfume, and I smell like our mother. Her parents love her, and mine almost devoured me at birth. It's hard to talk about. I just need like 1 second. I just need a second. I just need like 1 second, you guys. Yeah. That's better. She can speak 3 languages, and I only know. So I guess I understand why you picked her. I'm so jealous of her with her perfect wavy hair. But last I checked, she never won a blue ribbon at the county fair. Take that, Courtney. Bitch. She likes to sip rosé and watch The Bachelor with her friends. But my best friend is a spider named Charlotte who writes me messages in her web. Like, humble, terrific. Some pig. She's a good friend. Your girlfriend, though. You and her could sell a sexy movie on OnlyFans. But a sex tape with you and me would only be accessible on the deep web. Because it's illegal. We just weren't meant to be, which hurts my small pink soul. Yeah, I'll never be like those other girls. Because I'm a literal barnyard animal. Thank you, guys. It's on YouTube.
No! Oh.
But you're good.
Did I come in too early? I'm sorry.
No, you got it.
Yeah. As Shelby was saying, it's on YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
And you'd probably just have to put Shelby Taylor in a search bar, would you not?
I think so, yeah. I think you'll get my channel if you just type in Shelby Taylor.
That is good. And you're on something else I noticed as well that comes out in a big list of stuff that you're on. I don't know what that
I'm on most of the things.
I know. But no, it's some sort of web page that's got all your social medias and stuff on.
Oh, yeah, that's my Beacons page and, like, all of my profile bios.
Yeah, the Beacon, that's a good thing, that Beacons page.
It's awesome, yeah. I love my Beacons page. Got all my stuff on it.
Excellent. And we can listen to you on Spotify as well, which is great. Mm-hmm.
I do have an EP on Spotify. That song is not on there, but it'll be on the next one whenever that happens. So,
you know, have you got, is that just a, that's going to happen at
yeah,
some
it's
point,
just so, like, yeah. Whenever I'm less poor, my Venmo is also in my Beacons, everybody. So.
Excellent. Shelby, I hope we see you again before we finish this live stream. I'm not sure. I'm in an hour if I'm going to do an extra show or not, but I will be in touch.
Yeah, let me know.
Hopefully. Because right. I love having Shelby Taylor on the show. Hey, Shelby Taylor! Bye. Thank you very much.
Bye. Have a good one.
Thank you. See, go to Spotify and listen to some Shelby. Go to a YouTube channel and do that Beacons thing. That Beacons thing is very, 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 very good. Very good. Now, we've got Wendy Mowbray with us tonight, and I'm so excited. And we've got Jess for the first time. I don't know whether to go and say hello to Jess, actually, because I think she's got a big following, and I just want to check out her webcam and her microphone. So we'll just go and say hello to Jess. Hello, Jess.
Hello, Steve.
Oh, that's all right. Yeah, no, I'm sorry. I keep missing you this week because things are going not so good for me, but that's all right.
And our time zones are like oceans apart.
That's right. You like, so whereabouts are you?
New York.
New York. see, I'm a man of 1,000 faces, which is good. So that's all right. I'll come back and speak to you in a minute. I just wanted to just double check with you.
It works.
That's good. And I'm going to get you on with Wendy as well, so you can think of some questions to ask her.
Oh, awesome.
Because I know you're a friend of Wendy's.
Yes. Is she in a truck stop right now? Tell her to get out of the bathroom. She's got money to raise right here.
I spoke to her about half an hour ago. She just showed me the view of her road, and it was like in the country. It was great. So I don't know if she's just going to pull up. Do you have lay-bys? I don't know what they're called. Turnpikes. I don't know.
Who's in South Dakota? There's only one road.
Oh, is there? Hey, she wants to come in. She wants to join the party. Hello, Wendy. Where are you?
Hello.
Yes. Look at all the fans you brought. There's all these people in the comments that can't wait to hear your hilarity.
So whereabouts are you, Wendy?
We are in western Minnesota on the way to South Dakota. It's beautiful plain country. And I have two wiener dogs in the back. But I'm going to pull over and be really official when it's my turn.
Okay. But I assume you just popped in to say hello.
Yes, I just want to tell you good luck, Jess.
Oh, thanks, Wendy.
Oh, bless. I'm going to see you both in a minute. There's Wendy in Minnesota, and that's Jess in New York. I'll see you both in a bit. Bye-bye. Can I do both together? No, I can't. There you go. Oh, look at that. How rude. I'll see you in a minute, Jess. That's so rude. Because we're going to go and see my mate Pete. I'm going to call him my mate Pete because he's helping me out tonight, so that's great. So, Pete, I'm going to come and say hello. Hi, Pete. You all right?
Hi, Steve. Hi, Wendy. Hi, Jess.
Hey, what are you wearing? What's that you got on there? Is that a football or a?
Yeah, it was a present. Actually, this is the American connection as well. It's a present from my daughter from USC in Los Angeles when she did about 5 months there. So she very kindly bought her father a football shirt, which kind of a great daughter, I think.
Yes. No, don't say that. My daughter will buy me one for my birthday.
She'll be encouraged. Children buying parents' presents, it should be encouraged, I think.
Oh, no, I definitely... She brought me a T-shirt for Christmas which just had pictures of my face on it. You can't argue with that.
Well, fair enough, yeah. Right.
That's good. How are you?
I'm very good. I don't know if you can see the super-sized banana I've got behind me here.
I was going to say, you're surfing in the USA.
It's a new thing they've done with fruit. You know, you can super-size your drinks. Well, I've done it with fruit, which I think is a great sort of... There's a picture of me in 1873 when I invented surfing, obviously.
Did you? You never invented surfing.
No, that is a lie. I've also got these. I don't know if you've seen these. Do you like these?
I don't even, what is it? Oh, I know what they are. They're those bungee cords for every car should have three.
But they're actually not. What they are to protect my new glasses, you see, because I've got some new glasses that I paid a lot of money for. And what you do with these is you fix them in the back of your shirt like that. And then when you have a drink and maybe another drink and then start maybe mixing your drinks and have quite a few drinks, when you fall flat on your face, these prevent you from smashing your glasses. Brilliant, see? I've just invented that. I'm going to patent that.
Hey, excellent. That is so cool. Hey, Pete, thanks so much for stepping in tonight.
Pleasure. Thank you for asking me. You're a gentleman and a scholar.
I certainly am. How's your theatre play go?
Well, we've had a bit of a problem with that, to be quite frank. We've filmed it, and the company that filmed it, for reasons best known to themselves, are not releasing the film. So, yeah, we're in a bit of a dispute about that one. So, you know, let's see how it goes.
Okay.
I'll keep you in touch. As soon as I know, I'll send you. Because we filmed it, and it's great, and it's some brilliant performances. It's about Helen Sharman, Britain's first astronaut. It's a story that needs telling. Great bit of writing, and a great company called Nothing to Perform. So fingers crossed we can get it out there. So, you know.
Oh, that'd be
soon enough, I'll let you know.
Smashing. All right, Pete, are you ready to do your stuff?
I am indeed.
Excellent. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm a friend of the Henn House. It is... Pete, what's your name? Picton! No, that's me. Fucking hell, I'll get this right. Let's do that again.
It's funny, that's what my dad used to say. Here he is, Pete, what's your name? Which number are you?
Oh, don't. Right, okay. So
he used to call me Steve, actually, my dad did. But anyway, we'll gloss over that for now.
My dad never did. All right, so thank you so much. Back in the Henn House, it's Pete Picton!
Thank you very much, Steve. Actually, just before we start, I was going to say to everyone, look, everyone watching, if I forget anything or get confused at any point during the set, don't worry, right? Don't worry. I'm just having an adventure before dementia. Anyway, you've been a great audience. Thank you very much. Good night. Sorry. It's my memory. Memory loss is getting, whatever. I mean, I keep forgetting things like I start forgetting where my wallet is, usually when it's my round. That's assuming I can remember it's my round in the first place. But memory problems, it's not just old people. Yeah, it's not just old people who have memory problems. I mean, everyone that's listening, do you remember that thing I told you a minute ago about goldfish's memory? Now, you see, you've forgotten already, haven't you? Nostalgia, yeah. It's another thing, nostalgia. That's not what it used to be either. But excuse me a little bit, because I am a bit nervous tonight, because I'm a bit out of practice for live comedy. You see, I was just starting to get somewhere with my act, and China deliberately launched a pandemic to foil me, which, you know, has been pretty effective, quite frankly. But I am a bit nervous. I'm more nervous than an 18-year-old taking the AstraZeneca jab. That's how nervous I am. I'm more nervous than a Zoom shareholder once lockdown ends. That's how nervous I am. Yeah, I'm more nervous than Keir Starmer at the next by-election. That's the sort of state I'm in. And you can tell I'm in a state because I got lost on the way here. I'm sorry I'm late, but I've got one of these new celebrity sat-navs. I don't know if you heard of these, but what they are is they use celebrity voices to give you directions, right? Sounds like a great idea, doesn't it? But my celebrity sat-nav's voiced by Fleetwood Mac, and it's rubbish, quite frankly, because it keeps telling me to go my own way. It's better, though, than the last one I had. That was Bonnie Tyler. That got me lost in France. And I had an AC/DC one that just sent me on a highway to hell, or the M6, as it's better known. But, I don't know. I just get confused about stuff. Like this self-identity movement, yeah? I tried it out, right? I self-identified as a lottery winner, but Camelot just threw me out of their offices. So, you know, it doesn't work for me, that. So I don't know. But, I did have a difficult upbringing. One Christmas, my dad gave me a flat bit of cardboard, told me it was an Xbox. And I've struggled with my career trajectory. I'm currently a price checker in Poundland, which is a bit repetitive, to be quite frank, you know. Price check on aisle two, please. It's a pound. It's always a pound. I mean, I struggle with a lot of things. I'm not very fashionable, never been fashionable. I caught COVID-18. But I tell you who I felt sorry for during lockdown. the house burglars, because you know, everyone locked at home, burglars have business plans completely knackered, wasn't it? You know, so you know, we might have a round of applause for the house burglars later on. But everyone got dogs during lockdown, didn't they? My wife's been taking all people's dogs for walks. It's good of her. She doesn't ask, she just sneaks up behind them and takes her dogs, you know. And of course, being old, they can't really catch her, can they really? But and everyone's been moaning about things being cancelled during lockdown, like festivals. Not me, pal. I'm going to have my own Glastonbury festival this year. What I'm going to do is I'm going to stand in my back garden for 5 days. And then the wife's going to empty a watering can over my head. And then I'm going to watch this year's Glastonbury live stream on Nextdoor's telly in the distance, because that's about as close as I usually get to the bands. And then just to complete the holistic Glastonbury experience, I'm going to get the neighbours to come round and smear shit all over my bathroom. Hey, Glastonbury, and I save a bit of money. But I tell you one thing about festivals. I don't know if you've noticed this, but whenever I go to a festival, you never see any robots at festivals, do you? And do you know why that is? I've done a bit of research on this. Do you know why you never see robots at festivals? It's because when robots try and buy tickets to a festival, the website always asks them, are you a robot? They've had it. Robots are furious about it. They've been emailing me about it a lot, repetitively. So, yeah. You're so old, Dad, my kids shout at me. You still use email. They think that's a funny insult. So, you know. But, yeah, I am old, and there's nothing wrong with being old, you know. I remember things like, I remember the miners' strike. Do you remember that? When everyone under 12 refused to work. Yeah, that was bad. But then again, you know, talking about the good old days, they weren't all good, were they? I mean, if you think the clocks going back is a pain, think how bad it was when they built Stonehenge, having to move all those stones twice a year. Anyway, I've got sheep that need worrying, so I'm going to leave you with this thought. If any of you have trouble sleeping, try one of those insomniacs. Try one of those insomnia apps. They're really good. They work really well. 5 seconds on one of those, the insomnia app, and you are fast asleep. Give it a go when you drive home tonight. Thank you. I've been Pete Picton. Thank you very much. Good night.
Pete Picton, thank you very much. Well done, Pete. Hey, Pete, are you staying around for the caption competition?
I am indeed, and I'm going to now think about some captions.
Excellent, excellent. That's very well. You can't argue with that, can you? That'll be good. If we did it like this, it would be closed caption.
Yeah, that's a very good idea, Steve. I like that.
Thank you very much. There you go. I don't know what that means either. So
people start to talk about us.
They've been talking about me for minutes. Right. Thank you so much, Pete. We'll see you again shortly. That's not a sizes joke to do the caption competition. Pete Picton, people. Thank you. I've got to do me. I think, I don't know. Do I do that? That's it. Whoa. Hey, thank you so much, everybody, for staying with us. If you're new to The Henn House, The Henn Nights, with me, disgraced magician Steve Henn, then please tell everybody how brilliant a time you're having. Unless you're just waiting, unless I'm just background noise and you're waiting for Jess and Wendy. But then there was a lot of people supporting Pete there, so that was good. And I hope if you are supporting our comedians, you do scan this code with your phone. Just get your phone out now, open the camera app and hold it up to the queue, and it'll take you to PayPal, and you just donate £3. Buy us a cup of coffee. Why not buy us a cup of coffee? I say us. Buy me a cup of coffee. Right, where are we going now? We've done Pete. We got... Oh! Yes, indeedy. We're going back to see Av. Oh, this is my favourite bit, because I wake him up, because he lies asleep. Waiting for me to come and say, I'm going to go see Av Singh. Oh, there you go. Hi, Av.
I'm ready.
Good. Did you like your, you're locked in a jail thing?
I got lost. I'll be honest with you.
That's it. I ought to tell people that you go out and you do like roving reporters around the country.
I try. When I say country, around the country, it's more like
around my neighbourhood.
Ah, okay. When you say country, I always think of a fanny bush.
I've never met her.
Sometimes it just comes out of my mouth, Av, I'm sorry.
Okay. Again, Americans have a different understanding of the word...
tree.
Bush. He was a president three times.
Yay. And I suppose, considering the president they had before, and why do you, I don't know, he's probably one of the better ones now.
Yeah, probably. He was the worst, but then who came along?
It's like this country. We can only have a better prime minister from now on.
Oh, I don't know about that. Keir Starmer.
He was never going to be a prime minister. Never. So don't worry about that. He's got to find a party he can win it with first. So, did you watch Boris's speech today?
I watched a little bit of it. It was interesting to see that Scotland and Wales are holding back on opening up. But Boris...
Oh, because we're opening up... He said we're still going ahead.
As Monday as planned. Yeah.
Oh, man.
He's concerned about it, but not enough to slow it down, shall we say.
Well, no, but, I mean, I think that's the story of his life, because he was concerned about it and he didn't slow it down, and now he's got 28 children.
Right. That's what I was going to say. He's never been cautious.
Sorry.
Even when he's having sex.
I'm sorry, did I? I apologise there. I walked all over your punchline.
It helped it, actually, if anything.
No, oh dear God! I don't know. So we got. I'm going out next week, first time. Going to see some stand-up comedy in Moseley. Oh. So that'll be nice.
Good luck.
People laughing. I don't know if we're allowed to sit next week. I think we're probably in the tables of six situation.
I'm just wondering if anyone would anyone overcompensate? Well, a lot of people overcompensate. You know, because they ain't been out for a long time, have they? So you see the news, people over drinking, getting a bit loudish, you know, fighting. Imagine a comedy club. Yeah. Imagine a comedy club. And be like, we haven't started yet.
Oh, I'd go down really well there, wouldn't I? People would laugh.
Yeah.
Oh, excellent. My shittest joke would get a chuckle.
There'd be people just laughing outside, ready to get in.
Let's hope so. Hey, I'll let you know how things are going with that. That would be fun.
Yeah, I look forward to performing to an audience at some point. Hopefully, that's live.
Yeah. I mean, we used to perform to an audience, but that was in the car park of the local park.
Good.
Honestly, I don't even think it just comes out. So, we got that to look forward to. I do think Wales and Scotland have had it a lot righter than we have, but you never know.
Yeah,
we've got more vaccine now. We've got more people getting vaccinated, and that's a good thing.
Well, I was watching on the news today. There was Bristol, because that's when they've got a few cases of the Indian variant.
Oh, God, yeah.
Some pharmacies giving it out to people in their 20s.
Giving it large.
I think you're showing your age there, Steve.
that's showing me age.
Yeah, give me the 20s. So they were you're distracting me. They're in the 20s, and I lost my train of thought there.
Sorry.
Were they anyway getting the after morning pill?
What? What's an after morning pill? Do you get those at funerals?
I've got it mixed up. Your pill.
The morning after pill.
Is that what I said?
You said the after morning pill.
The after morning pill.
Oh, granddad's dead. Have an after morning pill. That'll make you feel all right. You might have a baby, but don't worry about it.
Yeah, that's there's two different types there.
Can I just apologise for that accent? And if I offended anyone, I do.
Yeah, that Irish accent was terrible.
To be sure. So, yeah. So they're getting vaccinated at 18?
Yeah, yeah. They're like 18, 19, 20. They're queuing for 4 hours.
Really?
Yeah. They're so scared of the Indian.
Yeah. I'm not going for that. I'm not swimming into your pond.
There's Indians around Indians around in Bolton. Shit. Let's get out of here.
The only
Indian variant I'm concerned is Preeti Patel and Rishi Sunak.
I know, but you see, now that's difficult, isn't it? Because you can't blame their ethnicity on them being dicks. It's just that they are.
Well, politicians.
Are we getting into a deep swamp?
In general, are bellends.
Yeah, in general.
In general, don't matter what part you're part of. You go to a politician because you're looking for a career and you want to get a good pension and you want to be in charge of some decision making and screw people's lives over, even if you think you're doing it for the better for them. You're not.
Did you just call me a nut?
Are we talking about Prince Harry?
No. I don't understand. I really don't understand why people get so fixated about the spare.
Well, he's a, you know, he's a ginger nut.
I called him a ginger biscuit. I didn't call him a ginger nut. I wonder if he's got.
I was wondering if Meghan fancies a ginger nut every so often.
All right. Steady.
What? The biscuit, you know.
Yeah. I know where you're going with that.
Yeah, it depends how she wants to dunk it, I don't know.
I knew you were going to go there! Stop it!
She likes to dunk a ginger nut every so often, imagine, don't she?
Look, when I was younger, our milkman used to have ginger nuts. Coincidentally, so did my brother when he got older. Let's not do that. Av, we're going to go and see Jess, because Jess has brought the fan club, I think. I think it's Jess. It's either Jess or Wendy. So we'll see. So it could be you. How many? I mean, it could be my fan club. But they said that they were having a meeting of in the phone box. So that was all right. So, yes. Av, we'll see you in a bit. Thank you very much. Glad you're feeling better. Av Singh. And now, ladies and gentlemen, who have we been waiting for? I'm not sure. I'm going to find out. I'm going to say hello to Jess, then we'll bring Wendy in. Jess, hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
You've not seen this show before, have you?
I've not.
No. Be honest. What do you think?
I'm a virgin.
Yeah, so am I.
That's why we're good for each other.
That's it. But I never take my tights off. So, what do you think of poor old Wendy's going? He did say that. I've seen it. I've seen his thing. Why has he said these things? Yeah, no. Go on, tell me. What do you think of the show? Be honest.
It's fucking awesome.
Yeah.
The best one I've had at 3:50 in the afternoon on a Friday in a long time.
Of course. I forget that you're in the afternoons. Do you know where is Wendy 3:15?
No, she's like at least 2 hours behind us.
It's 12. No, 12:15? No,
like two.
Two.
But never mind the math.
Both my son and my daughter got degrees in maths, and I don't know where they got it from. It certainly wasn't me taking two from three. Okay, so have you been doing comedy long?
No.
Oh. What do you mean, no?
Not very long. I mean, like, professionally, or do I think I've been doing comedy for a long
time? Oh, no, that's right. I've been doing comedy since I was taking my nappies off, which was only 10 years ago, but that was something else.
I think I'm funny, but, you know.
So do I. Right, should we bring in Wendy? Because Wendy sent me a message and she said, you've got to have my friend on your show. Here she is.
Hello. Oh. Hello.
What's that doing in your face? We've got to get rid of that.
Nobody wants to see your face.
There you go. There you go. Now. Don't need to never see Wendy again. No, so my girlfriend Jess here, she's coach. We have, in America, you know, when you suck at something, you get a coach. And so Jess is coaching me on one thing. And she goes, well, I really want to be a comedian. I'm like, oh, I can help you. So we've been working on her comedy together. And I said, there's no better place to lose your virginity than with Steve.
Exactly.
I don't even know if that's a good or a bad thing.
It's honest.
No. Hey.
You're gentle. You're a goofy hat. That's a lot.
I'll be gentle. Brace yourself. No, listen. No, you're right. It's nice. And it's a good, and it's a friendly, and it's a warm thing. And we're not hitching. But I think that's a great thing that Jess was teaching you something, and now you're teaching. And you're actually there to say that Jess is your protege. And so if anything goes wrong, you're here to support her.
I am. Jess is going to be great. I'm not even worried about it. Jess, go slay them. All these people are waiting for you.
The fan club is here.
Do get them to donate as well, Jess, because honestly, this hat doesn't cost pennies. So,
you guys, you can say you donated to the first one.
Yeah, you only have to donate once. Wendy, are you pulled up? Is that a good thing to say?
I'm in the tiny town of Olivia, Minnesota. I'm here to watch Jess, and then I'll give you some comedy.
Oh, excellent. Can you go to the side again? Is that a little picnic bench the other way?
Yeah, it is. It's a tiny little... we're really in a little tiny spot. So it's just a little town. This is the main street of a little town. You can see how much traffic there is.
This is better than comedy, I'm thinking. We got geography. Excellent. Yeah. All right. Wendy, we'll see you in a minute. Thank you very much. Wendy is here to support Jess. Jess, are you ready then?
I'm ready. Let's do it.
Oh, this is exciting. First time?
First time ever.
Okay, I'm going to do this then, as Wendy told me to here. I'm going to be very gentle. Ladies and gentlemen, the first time in the hen house.
Nice.
Jess Marcy. Oh, that's me. Even my... All right.
Hey, you guys. Shout out to CBA. If you know what CBA is, you know what I do. I am a clutter coach. That is, I help people ditch their crap. So I'm like a ditch your crap coach. That's how I met Wendy. I am also a mom. I have two amazing, smart, beautiful daughters. And I'm a wife. I have a husband. I have to tell you, as a wife, I can remember the exact moment that I learned the difference between moms and dads. Back when my girls were littles, I had the incredible opportunity to go to the grocery store all by myself. Now, let me explain. My husband is a man, and as such, he's never been to a spa, never had a pedicure, and never gone grocery shopping. So when I mentioned that I was stressed, his suggestion to hit the grocery store alone was essentially the same as him suggesting that I take a tropical vacation. Needless to say, I jumped at the opportunity. I left my loud, chaotic home, but returned to a freakishly quiet house. I found my husband alone in the basement, excitedly fawning over his long, hard, black straw, which had just arrived in the mail. I'm talking about a life straw, obviously. And my husband couldn't be prouder of the investment that he had made in our family's post-doomsday future. He reminded me that you can only go for 3 days without liquids. And it turns out that along with MREs and night vision goggles, a life straw is pretty much a prepper's dream. Why? Because no matter how dire the circumstances, that life straw is always suckable. If you're experiencing a nuclear fallout, no problem. Keep sucking. Viral COVID droplets everywhere? No problem. The straw slides right underneath that mask. You can even suck on this straw after the volcano explodes. I was beginning to lose focus on this conversation because, frankly, I just don't care. And all of a sudden, the quiet of the house feels strangely unnerving. Then it hits me like a ton of bricks. My husband has no fucking idea where our kids are right now. Like, where the fuck are the kids right now? Do you even know if they are alive in this moment? Where are they right now? Here he is, fully prepared for life after an apocalyptic event, but he has no idea where the kids are right now. They could be wandering around in nuclear fallout, joining forces with the zombies, or shopping at Walmart without a face covering. Where the fuck are the kids right now? That's when I realized the difference between moms and dads. As a mom, I worry and prepare for things that are actually going to fucking happen. The kids are gonna get hungry. I will need to feed them. The kids are gonna get dirty. I will need to bathe them. The kids are gonna disappear when their dad is watching them. I will need to find them. Dads have the luxury of living in a goddamn fantasy land and preparing for things that are never going to happen. Not only that, but they expect you to actually be grateful for all of the time and money they waste on these so-called preparations. Of course, here's the irony. We are living in 2021, actually living through a pandemic right now, and I am at capacity. The only thing that I'm sucking on these days are gin and tonics. And when the aliens start invading, hand me the cyanide punch. Jim, I'm coming home. I am going down with that shit. I have no desire to find out about life on the other side of a nuclear holocaust. No, thank you. Take your fucking death straw and suck it yourself. That's it.
I see, because we didn't have a chat. I didn't tell you, let me know when you finish. Ah, hey. If seriously, if that's your first time, you should be very proud.
Oh, thanks. It was really fun.
Oh, no, that's excellent. I'm so, so pleased for you. And I'm so, so pleased for me. And because it's so nerve-wracking to do stuff like this. And you did really, really well. And you've got a lot of support. Bobby. Bobby's on, not next week, the week after. Bobby's giving you some clappage.
Thank you.
That'll be good. Oh, I'm so, in fact, what I'm going to do, I'm going to donate myself. I'm going to scan that code and I'm going to donate to Jess as well. So everybody else with me, donate to Jess, scan the code, open the link, just press a button, enter your credit card details. Hey, that's so cool. I tell you what, because I think I should get you on every week.
Yeah, let's do it. I want to practice every week. I'm on.
There you go.
Friday afternoon.
That's the thing. Do you declutter normally? I mean, do you have to? I mean, is it a job that you have with lockdown? Have you been able to go into people's houses? There we go. Do you have to go into people's houses?
Yeah, no. So I work entirely remotely. So I don't go into anyone's house. Just talk to them on Zoom. We talk through it.
I was just going to take the camera off and show you my space. But I've decided against it because I realised everybody else will see it. I tell you, I have more floordrobes than anyone else.
Oh, my gosh. That's a great term, floordrobe. You know, floor space isn't storage space.
I know. I think I learned it off my children, weirdly. But I think that's a great thing because more people are wanting to declutter anyway. So what do you actually look at them and say, you've got to do this? How would you... I've not taken any. I don't. What do you have to do?
No,
you
have a consultation. You want to hear the whole thing. So I believe that clutter is just totally part of our human nature, right? So hoarding has been an evolutionary advantage forever. And right now we're stuck at home. Our credit cards are saved on our computers. And, you know, Facebook is like God. It knows more about you than you know about you. And it predicts what you're going to purchase next. So it's like next to impossible not to bring stuff into your house. So that's really.
Oh, I'm so sorry about that. I got a touch screen. I moved my camera and my browser closed down on me. So I've left you. I have no idea what you said.
It was really good.
Of course it was. Of course it was. Hey, I'm going to see, because I think I'm going to do three more of these. I'm going to might get you back on the last show just good. Because I think what you've done tonight is brilliant. And
nice.
I just think it's... Because not many people give young comics a chance. I'm going to call you a young comic as well.
I'm only 19.
Let's see what Mummy Mulberry thinks. Wendy, what do you think?
First of all, Jess, you got to do a free commercial. That was great.
I know. How awesome was that? You're advertising for me. My secret plan is working.
But that's how I met Jess. It's like this whole year I've lost all these things. And so I was buying all this crap. And all of a sudden I was like surrounded by crap. I'm like, why do I have crap everywhere? And then I met Jess and she's been like, girl, you got to let that go.
So let it go.
Is it easy, Wendy?
What, Steve?
Is it easy to let it go?
No, that's why you need Jess.
That's the hard part. Yeah. What? But is she forceful? Does she like...
You know what I love about Jess, very seriously, is that she's matter of fact. She's like, look, everything that you have, either you throw away or the people that you leave all your shit to will throw it away. So like, just be really thoughtful and have things that you love around you and then let the rest of it go. And I think that's good. She's like a really good friend to have around.
I was thinking that recently because I'm getting older, that some of the stuff I think I spent so much money on that. What? And I thought, but my kids will come in and they just chuck it away. They're not going to, they'll just say, I don't want that, Dad.
And they'll be angry about it. So, you know, they'll be like mourning the loss and then they'll be angry
about it. I'll be furious.
Is that the legacy that you want to leave?
Oh my
All right,
God,
Jess.
I'll get really deep, you guys. We're gonna leave it. That's it.
Jess, where can people get CBA from?
CBA, prioritizeyoursanity.com.
Boom, Jess. Thank you so much. Oh, do you want to do the caption competition? Let's do the caption competition. Is Pete around? We can see if Pete's around and Av's here and Pete's here. I need to share my screen. Say hello to people.
Hello, everyone.
That's there we go. That's what I want to share. This is who's on next week. Not next week, the week after. We're on the side here. And the caption competition. Have you all looked at the captions?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Good. There's the first one.
Right. How about the bovine Grand National falls at the first fence?
Hey.
That was good.
Is that is that Boris's mistress Jennifer Curie getting caught in the gate?
Ooh. If not, it's a lot of bollocks.
Yeah, that's very good. How about this kebab's a bit raw?
is that
how
the
brown cow?
Oh no, brown cow!
I just thought it was utterly impossible.
Oh yeah.
Is that how they make Cowangate milk?
Okay.
Very good.
Is the black cow saying it's the udder gate?
Oh, excellent. No.
Nope. Elaborate fancy dress goes horribly wrong in Dorset. Good. Any more? That's a no then. All right. Let's go to our next one. Whoa!
Is that Tevez from Argentina saying I fancy going into Rio?
Oh, that's a good one. You should have saved that.
I think there's a flag in here somewhere.
I've got Man United finally overtake City in the wheelbarrow race.
That's a nice clean one. I like that. Rio Ferdinand releases his new summer glove range.
This won't hurt a bit. Yeah.
Now cough.
Yeah, exactly.
Is he saying handball?
Yay. Vet's fancy dress party goes disastrously wrong as cow also dresses as footballer. I thought it was too much. Good. Let's go to the one that says the one that needs no words.
I remember the first time I caught crabs.
Yes.
I remember it too.
I think Boris Johnson's talking to his doctor, and he says, doctor, and doctor says, yes, Prime Minister. And Boris Johnson says, yeah, I think I've cured that terrible itching around my groin.
Prime Minister shows his shellfish side.
Boris has very, very crabby hands.
I think Boris is saying, the one in my left hand is called Dominic, and the one in my right hand is called Lunch, and I'm going to smash them both.
Boris Johnson catches crabs 5 years in a row. Oh, no, that wasn't funny. Quick, somebody do a funny one.
Boris is a twat.
Hey! I wouldn't want one of them screwing up my arse. Right, thank you very much. Let's get rid of stop that screen. Oh, I've got to get rid of him. There you go. Hey, well, thank you so much for making the Hen House lovely. We're now waiting for our Wendy Mowbray moment. Hey, Wendy.
Yes.
How long have you got to drive? Are you going to be in time?
I still have 2.5 hours. We have about a 40-minute window from when I of driving from when I actually need to be on stage. And I've got to change clothes and put on a dress and look nice.
All right, so everyone give everyone a clap. Wendy, I'll tell you what, if you want, you can do as long as you want if it helps you for tonight.
Well, I have a little set list, so we'll see how it goes.
All right, so don't you worry about it because you're the last one. So, you know,
A wonderful show. Pete, you did a fantastic job.
Thank you all.
And thanks to Shelby.
I've been quite impressed. Yeah. Every week's been pretty good.
And I've been the pretty part of that.
Oh, God, you guys.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much, Pete. Thank you. Oh, I can't. I'm going to do it there. Thank you very much, Pete. Thank you very much, Av. Thank you very much, Jess. Wendy.
All right.
Good luck for tonight. Have a lovely time. I'll see you afterwards. But honestly, just do as much as you want. It's fine. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, in the Hen House, Wendy Mowbray.
Hello. Hi, I'm Wendy. If you don't know me, I'm a single mom. I live in the woods of Wisconsin here in the United States. I have a little 7-year-old, and we have been on top of each other for too long during the pandemic. He looked at me the other day and he goes, you got a wobbly butt, mom. And I'm like, yeah, I have a wobbly butt because of you. You made it wobbly. And he goes, not all moms have wobbly butts. I'm like, whose mom have you been looking at? And he's upset that he's the only one in the house. He'd like a dad. He keeps setting fire to crap. I'm like, you got to stop this. And he runs in and says, like, put on a dress. Here comes a truck full of daddies. So I've already met all of the firemen in our small town. My mom's not happy that I'm on the internet. She's like, baby, I don't understand why you have sex with strangers. And I'm like, mama, our cousins don't live up here. So it's how we do it in Wisconsin. I have this favorite friend actually in England, and I'm a little bit nervous because I think his friends are tuning in tonight. So I don't want to out him. But he told me this story. And I know you guys, this is a British show. You've had American comedians. This, to me, encapsulates some of the differences between Americans and Brits. So my friend in England, when he turned 13, he said he was having a moment in his bedroom. Do you guys know what kind of moment I'm talking? Adult moment, listening to, like, Pour Some Sugar on Me or something like that. And he closed his eyes when he was having this moment with himself as a 13-year-old boy alone in his room. And when he opened his eyes after he was finished, he looked over and there was a tray with tea and cookies from his mom. She had come in the middle of his adult time, seen him and thought, oh, he's going to be parched. I best leave him a little tray so he feels better when he's done. Look at my boy growing so big. I'm so proud. What? I'm like, oh my God, how did you ever face her again? He's like, we never mentioned it. That's the difference between Americans and Brits. I can't even fathom that. First of all, if my mom walked in when I was having one of those at 13, I would have got a Bible to the head. There's no way there would have been a peaceful finishing, and she sure as hell wouldn't have brought me tea and cookies. She would have given me, like, maybe laid hands upon me and threw holy water. It would have been bad. Anyway, have any roommates? I have a lesbian with 2 wieners. That's exciting. It's, she, my girl, my friend Cindy, who happens to be sitting with me, and her
her two wiener dogs in the back. Here's the deal about Cindy, and she's right here, so I'm just going to be really honest. I've known her for 20 years now. She's really logical. She's really down to earth. I love her because she gives me a dose of reality. However, Cindy has fallen into a rabbit hole of the internet about Bigfoots, the Sasquatches, like Yetis, but North American Yetis, right? And I think, you know, Google gens up stuff to make you believe that what you're believing is true, because she is full on convinced that Yetis are that Big Feet are a real thing. Bigfoot, Sasquatches. She's in. She thinks the government is suppressing the knowledge because she thinks that we would revolt if we knew the truth about Bigfoot. And there's something else about after Mount St. Helens, some guys drug out the Bigfoots. So she went on, before she moved up here, she's moved from Texas, she went on the International Bigfoot Locator Map and saw that we've actually, in my tiny town in Wisconsin, have had several instances of Bigfoot. The most recent one was 1976, but it's still a concern. She's still worried about it. The other day, I have a camera in my backyard. A large bear was in my backyard. I woke up in the morning and found out that a large adult black bear was in my yard. I'm talking about like 5 feet from my house. And I'm thinking, holy shit, I have a kid. This is very scary. And you know what Cindy said? She goes, oh, great. I'm so glad we have bears because they keep away from Bigfoot. So we don't have a Bigfoot. I'm like, what? We have an actual creature with claws, but that's good because now I don't have an imaginary creature lurking around my backyard. So she's really just thinking about me there. Actually, Cindy is fantastic. If any of you know any women that need any women, Cindy like dogs. Cindy's like, no, don't even do it. Okay. You might find a nice British girl. She's giving me a die face right now. This is what it's like to be friends with a comedian. As you drive them to their crazy gigs, stop over in a small town to do a show from England, and then drive the rest of the way to South Dakota. We're going to Billings, or what is it?
Brookings,
South Dakota. And with two wiener dogs to try and sell some t-shirts and make people laugh. Because that's what I do after the pandemic. And actually super grateful we get to be around people again. It's pretty exciting. By the way, you guys were talking about Harry and Meghan. Harry looked at the Queen and his dad with all that money and said, yeah, screw the money, screw the power. I'll have some more what that lady's serving up in the bedroom because we Americans are really good at sex. I'd like you to believe that. Unfortunately, I got dumped last week. I actually was dating a guy for 4 years. I've been dating this guy. He's like, if he was a Muppet, he'd be Sam the Eagle. Like, America, stick straight up his ass. Anyway, he dumped me last week and I'm pretty devastated about it. Because he dumped me because he wants to have sex with other people. Now, here's the deal. If he wanted to have sex with like a Russian contortionist, it was like, my vagina is next to my ear. I'd be like, you better hit that because that's crazy. I get, you know, life's short. Hit the Russian, you know, contortionist. But it's not that. It's just more chicks just like me. You know, single moms, flowery dresses. They like to watch Downton Abbey and the Great British Baking Show. I really literally feel like anyone with an English accent could say to me, you're a bloody wanker and I hate you forever. And I'd be like, oh, let's make babies. I just love the way that sounds in my ears. All right, let's do one more and I will get out of here. It's been super fun being here, actually. And I'm really grateful that you gave Jess an opportunity to do some comedy in front of her friends. If you're one of Jess's friends, give a little yay, yay, yay for Jessica. Let it hear for Shelby. Comment the comments around P. And then Steve, obviously, the amount of energy that you put into this show and F is really fantastic and amazing. And I love your glasses and hat. So I'm going to leave you with this. And this is wild and crazy. Are you ready? This is like on the edge. So buckle up, everybody. And by the way, I do have an album on Spotify. And if you want to help me retire, all you have to do is put it on repeat, turn the volume down and go to bed. And in the morning, you'll have given me 25 cents. It's pretty incredible. I also sell t-shirts. So you can find me on Facebook if you want. Here's the deal. So the guy that I was dating in the past 4 years, you know, as a woman, I think with dicks, you see them in public. Like when you go to the bathroom or whatever, you see some dicks. Men see dicks. Women don't really see hoo-has a lot. Like we don't actually go, hello, what you got under your pants? Great, let me take a look. Oh, look, she's like mine. Fantastic. Like we don't really have that with each other. So you're never really sure if yours is normal. I'm just going to put it out there. So I was at the OBGYN the other day. And by the way, I had the most embarrassing moment ever. I fell on her naked and it's not my fault. I think it was a safety miscommunication because she was like, scoot, 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 scoot. And I'm like scooting all the way to the end. And then she was done. She was like, that's great. Sit up. And I was like, wow, that was awesome. Buy me dinner. No, you can't say that. It makes the copay illegal. So anyway, I told my OBGYN, I'm like, you got to be careful when you're asking me to scoot, scoot, scoot. Because if you don't tell me, I'm going to fall like I did on my last OBGYN naked. And my OBGYN goes, oh my God, girl, you don't believe what happened to me. When I was brand new in my practice,
I was sit. This lady put her legs up, and I was sitting in the chair, and it was a rolly chair, and the chair got out from under her, and she face planted in this woman's hoo-ha, and then she had to be like this. Okay, let's go ahead with the rest of the exam. I laughed so hard, and like, you were the perfect doctor for me, because I get really nervous about being naked in a bright light when everybody's sober. I don't like my vagina to be seen that way. It's much better when it's dark and everybody's a little drunk, right? So I'm there, I'm naked, I'm exposed, and all of a sudden she looks at me and she goes, Wendy, you know, women come in all shapes and sizes, but you, and I thought, oh my God, whatever she says next is going to hurt forever, right? She's like, you look a little different and we can fix that. And I'm like, what? So did you guys know that you can get your waddle trimmed? Did you know that? That like, you know, your turkey waddle, you can trim it. You can just bring it up. You know, sometimes if it's hanging low, bring it up. That's a surgery that they will do to you. Don't let them do it. It's all lies. She's like, it's not going to hurt at all. It's going to be totally fine. No, it hurts a lot. Don't let anybody trim any parts of any of your business. Not a good time. So she did a waddle trim. And I thought that would make me more. Let's, by the way, you should check out the horrified expression of my friend of 20 years. Did you know I got a waddle trim?
No.
No, she didn't know.
I don't know if this is real or fake.
Oh, she got, it's actually real. You don't want to know. Anyway, so yeah, she trimmed. And I thought, so. Sometimes I had noticed that men seem confused. And then I thought maybe they're disoriented because she says that I look different down there. Trim it up. Let's go. You know, I'm 47. It's time to make some headway into this dating shit. They trimmed it. It hurt like hell. And you know what? No one's noticed the difference. And I'm so angry about it because men are so stupid about chick parts. Not one person's ever been like, did you have some work done in here? It's like renovated. Like there's a wall missing. No clue. I have no idea why I did that surgery. Okay, Steve, I have run us into a very uncomfortable spot with both my friend in real life and probably everyone on the internet. That's a new waddle story, so I'm going to let that go.
Waddle, waddle.
It's so uncomfortable. I will bring you back. Hello, Steve, come back.
That's not uncomfortable. I'm going to say to you, right? They haven't have seen it before, I would imagine, so they wouldn't know you've had the work done.
That's a really good point, but the guy I was dating probably should have made some sort of...
No, no, I agree, but then my wife has a haircut every month, I never notice.
That's true. I am, if I want that kind of attention, I need to date a lesbian.
Yes. Oh, a couple of points. Lesbian with two wieners, genius.
Thank you.
No offense, but
no,
like...
It's okay.
That's a nice line. And I was watching Facebook the other day and I saw your CCT footage of the bear. I nearly shat in the woods.
I know. And this is literally what she says to me. She goes, oh good, we have a bear. That means we don't have Bigfoots. I'm like, oh, what?
Would a bear kill a Bigfoot? Hold on.
Because she's done a lot of research. It's that bears are afraid of Bigfoots, not Bigfoots are afraid of bears, right?
All animals are afraid of Bigfoot.
I'm not.
Every animal, they're terrified.
And she said that they found unknown DNA of a monkey origin.
Primate origin. Unknown.
And someone's calling Steve, going, it's Steve's wife. Are you done with the show yet?
It's my mother. She forgets. Bless her.
Anyway, thank you for having us.
Thank you so much, Wendy. Good luck tonight. Where's your t-shirt? Are you wearing the t-shirts that you sell? I want to buy a t-shirt.
Well, one, the humor is my superpower, but I have one that says day drinking like a mother all day, no pants, no problem. So hit me up on Facebook if you want a copy. I will ship you one. I would love to, actually.
Oh, bless you. All right, thank you so much. Good luck tonight. Thank you so much for everyone. Bye bye, Wendy Mowbray. Oh, she went herself without me pressing the button. Thank you all so much for watching. I'm just going to watch as you tick it. If you've enjoyed yourself tonight, please do donate. Phil, donate. Buy us all a cup of coffee. $3. You can't go wrong with $3. Thank you, everybody, for being in tonight's show. It's been one of my favourite shows of the 50 that we've done. So, come back next week if you can. If not, then CBA. CBA is what you need to do. So, thank you very much for watching. We'll see you. We're not here next week. We're having a week off, but we'll see you the week after. Thank you. Thank you so much, everybody. Take care. Have a lovely weekend.
Fuck you. Goodbye. You hurt me for the last time. It's time for me to move on. So fuck you and goodbye. I gave you love and I hate it. Yeah, all of the time that I wasted. Fuck you, goodbye. You hurt me for the last time.